أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم dear students this is the part 3 of the lecture number 6 which is related to the soil classification systems in our today's lecture we are going to study about the unified soil classification system in our introductory lecture we focused on the US Department of Agriculture soil classification system which was based upon the texture or the particle size distribution of the soils in our part 2 that was part 1 we focused on the ASHTO soil classification system We solved few problems on it to better understand the ASHTO soil classification system where we needed the particle size distribution information and also we used the liquid limit and plasticity index of the soil as well. So we started with the older classification system and the modern classification system. In the older classification, USDA was discussed, and in the modern classification, we discussed about the ASHTO and the Unified Soil Classification System. USDA soil classification pyramid was discussed. We solved a few problems on it, correction which we apply. If there are gravels present in it, limitations related to the textural classification systems were also discussed in our part 1 of the lecture number 6. Then we discussed about the modern classification systems, and in our part 2 of the lecture number 6, we discussed in detail about the ASHTO soil classification system. The criteria needed for the grain sizes, plasticity, those were discussed, and the table for the granular materials where we were having three groups and six subgroups like A1, A2 and A3 materials. Silt clay materials where we are having four groups and two subgroups. A4, A5, A6 and A7 and A7 was subdivided into two subgroups A75 and A76 based upon those equations which are given in the footnotes of this table. Remarks and the importance of the group index was also discussed, that in general the higher the group index the less desirable is the soil for use as a subgrade. And a GI or the group index of 0 indicates a good subgrade material, and a group index if it's greater than or equal to 20 it indicates very poor subgrade material. Then we solved problem number 3, problem number 4, and we classified those soils. There was alternate method of finding ASHTO soil type using the plasticity chart was also discussed, and a simple problem number 5 was also solved to classify that soil. Now in today's lecture we are going to focus and learn about the unified soil classification system. Now the original form of this system was proposed by Casagrande in 1942. For use in the airfield construction works undertaken by the Army Corps of Engineers during the World War II. Now later on in 1952, with the cooperation of the US Bureau of Reclamation, this system was revised. The system standard reference is ASTM test designation D2487. Now there are few criteria for unified soil classification system. For example, the grain size criteria is that if particles are retained on the number 4 sieve, that is known as gravel, and if particles are passed from the number 4 sieve written on the number 2 sieve, but those particles are known as SiNd particles. Silt and clay particles are those particles which passes from number 200 sieve. We also need the coefficient of uniformity and coefficient of curvature information. Please kindly refer to the particle size distribution. Lecture to find out what is the coefficient of uniformity and what is the coefficient of curvature. Plasticity or plasticity chart is also needed in order to classify based upon the unified soil classification system those soils which we are classifying. Now this system classifies soils into two broad categories. First one is the coarse grain soils, the second one is the fine grain soils. We already know that coarse grain soils are gravelly and sandy soils, and fine grain soils are silts and clays. Now for coarse grain soils, if less than 50% passing through the number 200 sieves in a sample, those particles are known as coarse grained material. If 50% or more of the sample passing through the number 200 sieve, that soil is known as the fine grained soils. Now the group's symbols start with a prefix of G or S. G for gravel and S for sand. For fine grained soils, M stands for the inorganic silt, C for inorganic clay, O for the organic silts and clays. The symbol PT is used for the peat, muck and other highly organic soils. Now all soils are classified into 15 groups. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and they are subdivided into 15 groups. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and into 15. Now G stands for gravel. S stands for the symbol is S, silt, symbol is M, clay can be denoted by the symbol C, organic, O, PT is for peat or fibrous soil. There are subgroups based upon the behavior of the soil. For example, the well-graded, poorly graded, silty or clay, well-graded, poorly graded, silty or clay, and if you are having liquid limit information greater than or less than 50%. Further symbols are there to denote the behavior of the soil. For example, well-graded can be represented by the symbol W, and G is the predominant particle size, and this is the behavior of the second symbol denotes the behavior of the soil. For example, predominant particle sizes are gravels, so we can say GW, this is well graded gravel, and GP is poorly graded gravel, silty gravel and clay gravel as well. Now as we start from, as we discussed in our ASHTO soil classification system, that table is given in the left side, and then we answer yes no answers, and then we can move towards the right side and we can get a column in the ASHTO soil classification system if the particle size distribution information, for example, percent passing number 10 sieve, number 40 sieve and number 200 sieve, liquid limit information and plasticity index information is given, then we will reach to that column and we will say that this is the classification of the soil based upon A1 or A2 or A21 or A2B, something like that. Now in case of the unified soil classification system. Excuse me. We classify based upon the percent passing. If it's more than 50% of retained, if more than 50% is retained on the number 200 sieve, those particles are known as coarse grain soils. If 50% or more passes number 200 sieve, that is known as the fine grain soils. Then there is further division in the gravels and its sands as well. If more than 50% of coarse fraction is retained on number 4 sieve, those particles are known as gravels. And if 50% or more of the coarse fraction passes from number 4 sieve, those particles are known as sands. Further divisions are also given, like clean gravels, if you are having less than 5% fine, or we are having gravels with fines more than 12% fines, and the information about the coefficient of uniformity, coefficient of curvature, plasticity index are also used in the unified soil classification system. Once we answer those questions from the left and we go all the way towards the right side, we will come up with a group symbol, and this group symbol will give us a specific name. For example, well-graded gravel and poorly graded sand as well, or low plasticity clay. Gravels, sands, low plasticity clay, high plasticity clay divisions are also given in the unified soil classification system. For fine grain soils, we can also use the plasticity chart. And the plasticity chart, on the x-axis you will plot the liquid limit, and on the y-axis you will plot the plasticity index. There is an upper limit of soils that beyond this line no soil can exist, and this soil separates, this line separates the clays from the silts. There is a region where clay, low plasticity clay and low plasticity silt, if the plasticity index and the liquid limit intersect at this particular region, that region is known as low plasticity clay or low plasticity silt, CL and ML. Now if the result of the soil test fall above the U line, then the test will be repeated. If the point lies on the line, then both symbols will be written. Now let's solve a simple problem on it, then you will understand that how we can use that table. For example, the results from the particle size analysis of a soil are as follows. We are having percent passing through the number 10 sieve, it's 100. Percent passing through the number 40 sieve is 80, and percent passing through the number 200 sieve is 58. The liquid limit and plasticity index of the passing number 200 fraction of the soil are 30, so that is 30, and plasticity index is 10. You need to classify the soil by the unified classification system. So as we know that 58% passes from the number 200, thus it is fine grain soil, and we can use both methods, like using the table and plasticity chart. For example, this is the fine grain soil, liquid limit is less than 50 because we already know that the liquid limit is 30. So it's silts and clays, and we are dealing with inorganic soil. Plasticity index is greater than 7 because we already know that the plasticity index is 10. So we will end up with the soil classification of low plasticity clay. Now, based upon the plasticity chart, We already know that liquid limit is 30 and the plasticity index is 10, so it would be low plasticity clay. Now there is another problem, which is problem number 7. We need to classify the soil using the unified soil classification system. Percent passing number 4 sieve is 70, percent passing through number 200 sieve is 30. Liquid limit is 33 and plasticity index is 12. Now we can refer to the table 5.2, and the percent passing number 200 sieve is 30%, which is less than the 50%, so it is a coarse grain soil. Now we need to find out the coarse fraction as well. The coarse fraction is 100 minus 30, which is 70%. So the gravel fraction is equal to percentage retained on the number 4 sieve. Or if you simply subtract the 100 minus 70, it will be 30%. Now, hence more than 50% of the coarse fraction is passing number 4 sieve, thus it is sandy soil. Because in our previous table, we have seen that if more than 50% of the coarse fraction is retained on number 4 sieve, that is known as gravels. But in our case, in our problem, 50% or more of the coarse fraction passing from number 4 sieve, that is sand. Now we also need to note down the, since more than 12% is passing number 200 sieve, it is SMRSC, low the silty sand or clay silt. So for this soil, plasticity index is 33 minus 12 is 21, which is greater than 7, with liquid limit 33 and plasticity index 21. Let me show you here. Coarse grain soils, more than 50% of retained on number 200 sieve, but 70% is passing the number 4 sieve, therefore it's sandy soil. Now we are having fine content, which is more than 12%, and the plasticity index is greater than 7. So we are having clay silt, the sand soil. Now here we are having the comparison. Based on the texture and plasticity of soil, So AASHTO soil classification system is based upon the texture and plasticity, and USCS or the Unified Soil Classification is also based on texture and plasticity. Soil is divided into two major categories, coarse grained and fine grained, separated by number 200 sieve. Soil is divided into two major categories, coarse grained and fine grained, separated by number 200 sieve. Soil is considered fine grained when more than 35% passes the number 200 sieve, while a soil is considered fine grained when more than 50% passes the number 200 sieve. Now, number 10 sieve is used to separate gravels from sand. However, number 4 sieve is used to separate gravels from sand. Gravelly and sandy soils are not clearly separated here in case of AASHTO soil classification system. However, gravelly and sandy soils are clearly separated by the Unified Soil Classification System. Symbols A1, A2, etc. of this group are not well descriptive of the soil properties. However, if we see in case of the Unified Soil Classification System, well-graded gravel or silty sand or high plasticity clay and others are more descriptive of the soil properties. Organic soils are not well discussed in this system, the AASHTO Soil Classification System. Then the classification of organic soils such as OL or OH or peat have been avoided in this system. Now in this lecture number 6, we discussed about the textural classification, the AASHTO soil classification, unified soil classification. Textural classification is based upon naming soils based on their principal components such as sand, silt and clay size fraction determined from particle size distribution. The AASHTO soil classification is based on sieve analysis and also the liquid limit and plasticity index. We divided them into A1, A2, and A3. Those were known as granular soils, A4, A5, and A6, and A7, silty and clay soils. Now, group index is also added to the soil classification, which evaluates the quality of a soil as a subgrade material. And if GI is equal to 0 or very, very small, then it's considered to be a good material, a good subgrade material. But if we are having greater value of the GI, or even greater than 20, that is considered very poor material for the subgrade material. So unified soil classification is based on the sieve analysis, and it uses classification symbols such as GWO, GP, and so on. For coarse grain soils, CLML and CLML or OL, CH, MH, and OH for fine soils. In addition to group symbols, the group names under the unified soil classification system can be determined using figures, and the group name is primarily based on the percent retained on the number 200 sieve, percent of gravel, and percent of sand, or percent passing number 4 sieves but retained on the number 200 sieve. Thank you very much for listening to my videos and lectures. I hope you are learning from these lectures and these videos. Please kindly like, share, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Assalamu alaikum and Allah Hafiz.